All right. It's actually been so long since I have just strapped on a chesty and went to the small little local lake and just kind of filmed that it almost feels a little bit foreign to me. But today we're going to be a little bit hard-headed. You know, I've been looking at the tournament schedule for next year. If y'all have not watched my channel before, I fish the Bassmaster Elite Series and also fish a ton of small little local lakes, especially the ones close to my house. But, you know, been kind of looking at the schedule and kind of figuring out which techniques and patterns and stuff we're going to play next year. And a couple of them I need to improve on, so that's what I've been doing. But today, we get a little bit back to the basics. I kind of just want to set the hook a couple times, you know? And I got a couple jigs on the front deck, and I'm going to show y'all kind of what I look for to be stubborn this time of year, and the way that I like to just pick apart water and cover water with a big fish catching bait like a jig. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to just be hard-headed, and we're going to show exactly what happens over the next 2 or 3 hours and see if we can't catch a few. So without further ado, let's go set the hook a few times.
It's going to be the number one bait right there today. Half ounce, little skipping jig. This one in particular is the ace. Straight green pumpkin, half ounce. And then I actually got the replica cleanup crawl on back. A lot of action in that cleanup crawl. A lot of really consistent action too. Consistency is a big part of a bait, especially when you're gonna be grinding with. Whenever I'm picking apart a place, I like to go really, really fast, but at the same time, you've got a couple different places you've got to cover. So if I had to pick a couple of casts per dock, it's usually gonna be the darkest shade over the deepest water and the darkest shade over the shallowest water. If I had to just pick a couple places to key on, that's what it's gonna be. And then after you get it kind of figured out a little bit, then you can slow down. If you figure out an area where you think it's just one area where it's the best, then you slow down and pick apart the dock big time. And if you think it's a pattern, you speed up and just say, hey, they're on the shallowest, hey, they're on the deepest, whatever it may be. You just want to maximize your time. And it sounds crazy to say maximize your time whenever it's a grind. That's what you have to do, because if you get 7 bites and someone else gets 6, you got a better shot of catching a big one, you know. And that's just the way that I think about it. And if you're really efficient, you'll actually get 12 or 13 bites and somebody else gets 6 or 7, so you're catching twice as many as they are, and that's a big difference. Cool thing about throwing a trailer like this that catches a lot of water is I can literally just go down the bank with one rod and I can swim this up there down that seawall, swim it across wood, swim it in grass, whatever I want to do. Makes it kind of a good bait just having your hand, you know. But obviously I might be throwing a little different bait if I was geared up for fishing like this, but I just want to catch them on a jig, man. I like setting the hook. Just water's pretty clear. So this is a really telling dock, in my opinion. It's got a really good platform. Somehow I hit that pole. It's got a really good platform up there. It's got a lot of shade up there in the, you know, 2.25 foot range is what it looks like. It's about 2 foot deep right there where I just casted. And it's also got a, oh, I missed him. Got my leg. That felt pretty good. He bit it again. Must be a little spot. You hold that sucker for a second. Dang it. Now he got both legs. Ain't no leg left now. So if you get something, it's gonna have to be the hook. All right. So he actually got me twice. This one I'm throwing. This is the green pumpkin blue pearl. You can see that? Let me clean the screen up a little bit. Green pumpkin blue pearl. Not really making an adjustment so far because, you know, a lot of times I talk about making adjustments a lot. But this is just kind of what we started with, and it's working, you know. A little bit more of a polarizing bait. It's got a lot of action to it. Usually cut it about right there. And I'll actually take these appendages off. Sometimes I'll leave it on. Kind of, probably doesn't really matter. I like the appendages a lot whenever I'm flipping it by itself. But when I'm putting on the back of a jig, I just kind of want it to be a little more streamlined, you know. So I just take them off. Still got that really good action of the legs and less drag in the body of the bait. So that's it. Small, a little bit of a compact profile, but lots of action. Yep. Put that back under. I'm sure he's probably halfway across the cove right now, but anyways, what I was saying is this is a really good dock because it's got the individual shallow platform, individual deeper platform. Really a dock that can key you in on what's the deal. Even though, so it's not that this platform's deep either, you know, 5 foot probably, but there's one. Oh, I lost him. Dang, got a little largemouth. Everything felt good on that. Anyways, what I was saying is the platform's not deep. It's just a lot further off the bank and it's deeper than that. That's probably 2 foot. That's probably 4.5, 5 foot. Unfortunately, that last fish was swimming right at me when I set the hook. There's another one. Dang, second dot, got 3 bites. trying to figure out what looks so different right here. I was like, man, what's going on? Something looks weird. Now I looked up, there's a stump right there with a tree missing. So that was an overhang tree right here for my whole life, pretty much. That is now gone, which I never caught none right here, no way. But the trees make some good shade right there, and I threw under it confidently a lot. It just never paid off that I remember ever. Looks like a really good place to break one off on the side of them concrete steps. Just skip the, how many docks was that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 docks. Had a bite on the second dock. Kind of going with the shallower dock pattern right now. Little row of docks right here. They aren't hardly deeper than 5 or 6 foot on the tip of any of these. And obviously shallower underneath. Back when this was a good lake, I could come out here and all of these shallow docks, you catch largemouth, largemouth, largemouth. Like they don't live here no more. Out of position on him a little bit. Got a meaty spot. That thing. That's how them spots look in the fall. They get gold, they get pretty, and they get thick. Couldn't resist old little green pumpkin. It's a good one. Felt him bite it. He was gone with it. I actually felt the bite before I even had engaged the reel. All right, gotta make an adjustment. I know it's a grind out here, but I just skipped 15 more docks or so and that many bites. Let's roll. All right. had a little one messing with it. So far it's been all about floating docks. It's a little bit unique for this time of year, I feel like. A lot of times I catch them on the other types this time of year. That's what they want, though. That's what they want. Pitch that old waste up here beside whatever that is. You know, I'm going down the bank and I'm flipping this jig to anything I can see, and I'm obviously swimming it down these banks and stuff. These fish like the wolf pack in the fall, looking for bluegill that are up there on the bank, and shad if they get up there a little too close, or crawfish or whatever. Especially after the lake kind of turns over, they really get up there and start cruise around. There's a lot less oxygen out deep in the early fall, so they get up there and cruise. I really only anticipate getting a bite or two like that this time of year, you know, but usually it could be some really big ones. But as tough as the bite is, you know, it's just a way to stay productive in between the hot spots, which, you know, a lot of times are these docks that I'm skipping under. You get a bite or two in between them, it makes a big difference at the end of the day, especially if it can be, you know, a quality fish, which a lot of times when ones that are up super shallow this time of year are. I would say definitely this type of year, especially if I can get bit in a foot of water, I always think it's going to be the biggest fish this time of year, you know. But a lot of times it's tough to get bites doing that, you know. Sometimes it's just on, sometimes it's far from it, you know. But you kind of see the places I'm keying on. It's really kind of the four corners of a dock. There's steps back there, just a little something extra, but it's not really popping off today. Had two solid bites, and I don't know, I don't even know what time it is, but two pretty solid bites, a couple small little bites that I know were no good. And that's kind of where we are right now, just kind of pitching a jig around. Strike zone this time of year, I feel like it's very big. They just get in the mode of. You can see I make a change. It's just two jigs, you know, but they're a little bit different. It's only a little bit, but it is a big difference as far as efficiency goes. This one I've got right here is a new one from Untamed Tackle. It's a flipping jig, heavy cover, still pretty compact flipping jig. You can see it's got a small skirt on it, thin cut skirt, just like the Ace does. Got the same Crest City cleanup crawl on it. This one's a 1/2 ounce. The big difference is because of the head design and where the lead is actually at on the head, it makes this jig fall straight down, like head straight down. The Ace is a super good skipping jig, super good, pretty good swim jig, super good skipping jig. And I've caught a lot of fish flipping it also around pole timber, stumps, stuff like that. I really like that. But when you're trying to flip heavy cover, you need something that falls straight down so it pulls that jig through the cover, all the way through the cover. And you know, the ace you can get it through there, you just can't get through there quite as quickly and quite as efficiently. So it's kind of why I switch it up. When I'm skipping docks, I get it under there and it's in a big, you know, open spot. When it finally gets under there, that's whenever I want it to have that really good action, that gliding action, looks really, really natural in the water, and how good it skips makes it a superior dock jig. The way this jig is set up makes it a very, very good flipping jig, you know. And I've caught a lot of fish on this thing at a brush. I've actually had these samples for quite some time now. I got 6 of them and I've still got 3 or 4 of them. So that just shows, I mean, these things don't get hung up. I've been fishing with them for months and months and months and I've still got them. I mean, you got to kind of work to get these things hung up. They're really, really good at coming through cover, coming through grass, coming through all that type of stuff. So that's why you see me switching up. I reach all the way down and pick up a different rod and it's still got a jig on it. So I just kind of wanted to tell y'all what the difference is. But you can see how it's got kind of a flipping jig, kind of a head to it. That one's all beat up, been fished with a lot. But switch back to the good old ace, skip under a dock real quick. Both of these are a half. I just like a half until if I got an area, if I think there's one creek where there's more fish in than anywhere else on the lake, I'll drop down to a 3/8, something like that. You know, if I'm fishing 3 foot deep or shallower all day, I like a 3/8 better for that too, you know. When I'm searching for them, it's almost always gonna be a half, just cause you can just go a little bit faster. And that makes a big difference. A really big dock right here that got a lot of shade under it. Should be money. All right, while I'm trolling to the next dock, I'll just tell y'all about the setup I'm using. 13 Fishing Concept C reel, 8.3:1 gear ratio. Y'all have seen me throw that reel a ton this year. This one's been fished with a ton, but 20-pound Sunline Shooter. That's gonna be my standard for a jig. If y'all seen any of my other jig videos, y'all know that's the standard. Look at them teeth marks on that sucker. Already quite a few teeth marks on the head of that jig. But 7'3", medium heavy, extra fast Muse. That's the setup. These Muse rods are really, really light and powerful. I'm a big fan of these. I'm gonna start using a lot more of these. These came out this year and making the transition to them pretty quickly. Still gonna use the Envy for a lot of stuff, but this Muse is, I mean, just as light as the Envy, if not a hair lighter. Man, it's got a ton of power. It's kind of crazy they could get this much power in a rod that's this light, but I'm with it. And it looks good. Black on black, blacked out with the white reel. Baller. But that's the setup. Like I said earlier, it's a 1/2 ounce Untamed Tackle Ace Jig. Crush City Cleanup Crawl on there. Phenomenal little crawl bait. If y'all watched any of my tournament videos from Seminole, Lake Okeechobee, Sabine, Lay, a lot of those places where I caught fish on a swim jig, this was the trailer I was throwing all year. On Seminole, was most of the fish that I caught was on a black and blue Apex swim jig with a cleanup crawl trailer. Then on Lay, I caught a couple key ones on it. And then on Okeechobee, I caught quite a few fish on it that I ended up not weighing. If I did catch a bunch on it, if the bite ever got tough, I could get them to bite the swim jig better than I could the frog was down there, but they seemed to be only males. Couldn't get the females to bite the swim jig. So didn't weigh any on it, but I did catch quite a few on it. But it's just been a really, really good trailer so far. I need to check these out if you like a crawl. It's got a lot of action. I'd say it's similar to it's like a Menace, but got more kick to it. And a little bit different kick. It's a longer, wider kick. Really, really good jig trailer. Flipping bait, whatever. Oh man, got me a little one, real little. Teeny tiny. He looked like he was about born in June, probably. So I got a dock like this. Got there's big. There's a lot of shade. There's one on there. Largemouth. That's what I was about to say is, when I got a dock like that, that pretty thing. Nice one. There's a ton, like two big boat slips and then some, obviously posts and stuff in the middle. That's where I'll normally go, is just right down the posts. Kind of right where he was. Just right, because there's a lot of shade. I lost that one. There's a lot of shade all around, so if you can mix the shade with some posts, I feel like you're even better, you know. So I go right in the middle of them typically. And I can't see a lot of times when I try to skip under there, there'll be a I can't see under there though. There's a metal boat lift right with level with the water. I can see it on that side. Doggone something under that dock. It's a nice spot. Just caught a largemouth. I caught a pretty spot. Fat sucker. And I lost one under that dock. That was the same thing. I went right to the next set of posts. Skipped under it. Had another one. When I hit that one, dude, he felt like he might have had something to him. But he didn't. So the people that know me know that I like to go fast. Like to fish fast, like to fish shallow, visible cover that I can see. It's actually pretty funny because a lot of y'all that have been old school subscribers and watched me since back in the day know kind of how I fish and how I fished when I qualified for the elites and how I fished before and didn't even have a depth finder on the front graph until my second year on the elites, you know. So it's like, you know, just kind of what I like doing. So it's cool to come out here and get back to it. That was one of them bites, one of them random ones. right. Trailer keeps sliding down. I'm gonna show you how I rigged this thing up. I cut it off right there about the top of that little texposing piece of plastic. It's got little ribs on it to help with texposing. So now you got that. Slide it up on there. Just about out the bottom of it. So I get it to there. So the Untamed tackle jigs have about the best trailer keeper there is. It's got four prongs on it, but I still just give it a little drop super glue. Slide up over them prongs right there. Make sure it's good and straight. And the main reason I do that is no matter how good the hook, the bait keeper is, the bait's always going to want to move, roll. Even I've tried the screw ones, still nothing keeps the bait as straight and consistent as that little drop of super glue just to hold it. And I'm not talking about for 5 minutes, I'm talking about for 2 or 3 hours, you know, of fishing hard and trying to skip and stuff. So when I slide that jig under them docks, it's going with a lot of speed. That's a lot of resistance on the skirt and the trailer. So that little drop of super glue really just helps. It don't take much at all. You put too much and you're gonna mess up your skirt sometimes. I use the gel, and then you can see I put it on top of the trailer and then slide it up. I don't put it on the actual jig and then slide the trailer up over it, because then it's already on the hook keeper and I feel like it gets in the skirt more that way. So I just put it on the soft plastic, and then it seems to like evenly disperse over the keeper when I do it that way. So it's kind of how I rig up a jig for maximum skipping efficiency. Another thing is when that trailer's secure, it skips better. I knew that was a little one, but I still set the hook on it. You don't want that trailer sliding down. That's why I thread instead of hang a chunk most of the time. And that's why I like a compact jig, because it just slides across the water so much better when it's compact like that. Now let's slide it into a fish's mouth. This little pocket I'm in right now is a dud. Shouldn't even be fishing here. That's what I do when I fun fish. I don't ever go to places where I know there's fish. I just fish tournaments and go there. I don't fun fish where I've been catching. Just how I do it. Only place in here I ever catch one right there. Literally. But I'm in here, so we'll fish it. Sometimes them rocks feel just like a bite. and then it just don't swim off. Caught a few on this side too, but literally about the only place I've caught them is one of these jet ski lifts. Come on now. Gosh. Took both my legs. We getting slim. Get slim on cleanup crawls. Also, if y'all can't tell, clamshell pack. It's kind of a standard this day and age, but I mean, you gotta have clamshells nowadays. It's too annoying to buy a pack of baits and only get half of them, sometimes less than half, that are actually straight and usable. But obviously they didn't invent the clamshell, but can't have a quality soft plastic without it right now. Little drop, slide it up, good to go. Couldn't even get it back under there. Sort of thumped it too. That's the culprit. Okay, he's hooked. He wasn't coming off of that. God, what is that? Oh no. Dang. That was unfortunate. he got me around that pole. Before I could even set the hook, he done swam around that pole. I never got him out. Dadgummit. Felt like a big one. I don't know if you can see that, but that says no wake. See his wake. How about that one? See his wake where he came from? That's all right, though.
Telling you, sometimes it feels like they hunt me down out here and try to ride by me. The wake boats and the jet skis. I was literally fishing a pocket over there, and there was one cutting a donut in the middle of the pocket. So I troll around and I come out of the pocket, go on the main lake, and they run ride right beside me like 10 miles an hour, making the biggest wave they could possibly make. So I think it's a probably a Facebook group around here or something where they go film how bad they can mess with bass fishermen and post it, and they all laugh about it. So I'd like to be in that group eventually, because I've probably made a few appearances on there without knowing it. But on a serious note, today was actually pretty fun. We I don't even know what time it is. We fished for about 2 hours. 2 hours and 20 minutes or so. 2 hours, 10 minutes, something like that. But it actually was pretty fun. Got to catch them. One of my favorite ways there is to catch a bass on a jig, especially around boat docks, shallow cover. The weird thing was, it was such a grind. You'd fish 10 or 15 boat docks without a bite. Then you catch two under one dock, or get two or three bites under one dock. And pretty typical for fall. Like I said at one point in the video, they like to wolf pack down the banks, and when they pull up under one of those docks just to chill out for a second, that's kind of when you gotta just catch one, you know, and kind of just get lucky and throw it in front of them while they're there. But really fun day. Didn't even turn on the old scoper at all today, and caught, I don't know how many, not that many, four or five fish, but in 2 hours, it's not terrible. Did lose one that felt really, really nice, but when I picked up, he was swimming underneath the back of the dock. And I set the hook, and he got me, he wrapped around a pole, and I just couldn't get him out from under that pole. Then he finally came off. So that's all you can do. And y'all got to see me flip around that new jig from Untamed Tackle. That is one that I have been catching a bunch of fish on, and we're going to make some really cool videos on that, because he's so such an efficient jig as far as getting in and out of heavy cover. So you can flip it almost as efficiently as you can a beaver, but got that jig profile, catch those little bit bigger fish. And sometimes when they get on those bluegill really good, they like that jig profile even better. And they like a beaver, so pretty fun. Pretty fun day. Hope y'all enjoyed that. A couple of little tips throughout there for early winter and late fall fishing, or just kind of just fall fishing with a jig. That's really a bait that still produces. So without further ado, I appreciate it, guys. And little outro went from the jet ski with a little bit of a help from the jet ski. He's clear over there. There's no wake buoys.